إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سجود السهو forgetfulness frustration when something extra you pray you put in your salah or you miss something in your salah or you are in doubt in your salah you need to rectify and then do the sujood sahwi. So in our last briefest lesson is we talk about aziyadat, extra you put in your salah, or an-naqsu, something you miss in your salah. And tonight, inshallah, we are covering ash-shakku. Ash-shakku, doubtness. And the doubtness we divide into two parts. If you don't know which one is right, for example, you don't know whether you are in the third rak'ah or fourth rak'ah. If you don't know at all, 50-50, there's a certain way to rectify. If you think you are made before the rak'ah, you count as a fourth rak'ah, and then certain way to rectify. It doesn't mean when you have doubt, you take the less number and carry on. It doesn't mean that way. It doesn't work that way. It is, if your doubt is 50-50, you take the less number and you rectify and you do sujood sahwi at the end. But if it is, you are outweighed, one of sight, you say, maybe I'm in the third, maybe I'm in the fourth. That maybe it gives more weight to what you think. And that means you build your salah on what you think, and then you do sujood sahwi. So the two types, the two sujood sahwi are different. The first one, 50-50, you do sujood sahwi before taslim. And the one is to outweigh it one side, you do sujood sahwi after taslim. It's not always you do certain way, and they are all the same. We'll see, inshallah. Ash-shakku, huwa, the definition of ash-shakku is at-taraddud, uncertainty. Your uncertainty, we have been bayna amrayni, between two matters. Am I in third, am I in fourth? So you're uncertain in between two matters. Ayyuma alladhi waqa'a, which one you done or which one occurred? You don't know. Washakku, there is, shak is one of the main gates which shaitan comes through. The shak or doubtness is one of the main gates of the shaitan. It misuses. So how you can avoid that? Washakku la yultafatu fil ibadat. Shak, don't recognize it, or don't look to it at all when you are in the worshiping, either wudu or salah or tahara. في ثلاث حالات إذا كان مجرد وهم, if it is just imagination, always you imagine something. You imagine. That imagination may not be right. So don't build your imagination something. لا حقيقة له كالوسواس whispering. ثانيا إذا كثر مع الشخص, if you are always or frequently you have a doubt. حتى لا يفعل عبادة, you don't do any عبادة, whatever it is, إلا حصل لك فيها شك, you're in doubt. You go to toilet, you are in doubt. Some water touches me, this water is not clean, this is this. You do wudu, you say, maybe I didn't wash my face properly, wash 5 times, 10 times. You start your salah, you are in doubt. Next salah, you are in doubt. Third salah, you are in doubt. If that's happening, how are you supposed to? إلا إذا حصل فيها شك, you should stop doubtness. And you pray whatever you think is right, without any doubtness. To close the chapter of the shaitan. ثالثا, الثالث one, إذا كان بعد الفراغ من العبادة, if you have doubt after you finish your salah, if you finish your salah, you have doubt. So what do you do? فلا يلتفت إليه. Don't take it in consideration. You pray the Isha, you pray four rak'ah, you say assalamu alaikum, and you say, maybe I pray three. After taslim, if doubt comes, ignore it. These points to close the chapter of the shaitan. Don't let shaitan to come to you through the doubtless. Normally, in where we grow up, when they start the salah, they say, Nawaitu usalliya lillahi ta'ala. And some people, you know, they say, Nawaitu usalliya lillahi. And shaitan tells them, you didn't pronounce correctly. He repeat, until Imam goes to ruku'. He missed the rak'ah. He went to the second rak'ah. When Imam stands up for second rak'ah, he starts, Nawaitu usalli, Nawaitu usalli. Nawaitu, no, just it, Nawaitu, Nawaita. And then Imam goes to ruku'. Until he stop the salah, and that's the day. Yeah. So if you start the chapter of the doubtness, yeah, it will open for you, yeah, until it throw you out of your ibadah. فَلَا يُلْتَفَتْ إِلَيْهِ Don't look to it. Yeah. Or don't put any consideration. مَا لَمْ يَتَيَقَنَ الْأَمْرُ Unless you are sure, once upon a time. فَيَعْمَلَ بِمُقْتَضَى يَقِينِهِ If you are sure, one of the times, You make mistake, you say, correct your mistake according to what you think. مثال ذلك شخص صلى الظهر Someone praying صلاة الظهر فلما فرغ من صلاته After he finished his salah شك he had doubts هل صلى ثلاثا أو أربعة When he got the doubts After he finished the salah. فلا يلتفت لهذا الشك. You are not looking back to that doubt. إلا أن يتيقن. Unless you are sure and you are certain أنه لم يصلي ثلاثا. You didn't pray except three. If you are sure that, correct it. So no doubtness standing after taslim. فإنه يكمل صلاته يفرج الصلاة يبريد ثري رقعة يسأل السلام عليكم أن يرمان بري يتسري لا تاونس يرمان بري يشوى يتسري يستاند أب أن يبرنك الفوث رقعة إن قرب الزمن ونجد تعمل شورت ثم يسلم يمدو تسليم ثم يسجد للسهو ويسلم يدو سجود عن تسليم again. In here, why he do سجود after تسليم? Who knows? Because? No, the pillar he missed, he brought it back. Mm-hmm. Extra تسليم. He done extra تسليم. We took that in previous lessons. Extra تسليم you saw now. You brought four, three, تسليم, and then fourth, and then تسليم. Yeah. So how many تسليم you done? Two. And تسليم you say it's rukun, isn't it? And in that case, you are doing your sujood sahwi after you finish. If you don't remember, until after a while, فلم يذكر إلا بعد زمن طويل. You prayed three, you left the masjid, you went home. On the way to home, or when you reach there, you remember it. And you are sure that you prayed three, not four. What do you do? أعاد الصلاة من جديد. You are bringing your salah all from the beginning. You are bringing your salah all from the beginning. وأما الشك if there is a doubt if you are in doubt في غير هذه المواضع الثلاثة other than these three situations. فإنه معتبرون, you have to consider that you pray a whole week, one salah, you are in doubt. You should try to think and rectify. If you are in doubt every day, two or three times, don't consider that. فلا يخلو أشك في الصلاة من حالتين. The doubts you have in the salah will be one of two. الحالة الأولى أن يترجح عنده أحد الأمرين. You outweighed one of the two matters. You say, did I pray three rak'ah or did I pray four rak'ah? I think it's fourth rak'ah. So that thing is outweighed the fourth one. So what do you do? فيعمل بما ترجح عنده. You build your salah according to what you think likely it happened. فيتم عليه صلاته. So if you think this is your fourth, what do you do? You bring the tashahud only at the final, isn't it? If you think it is third, what do you do? You bring another rak'ah, fourth, and then tashahud. فيتم عليه صلاته ويسلم ثم يشد للسهو ويسلم. Do تسليم and then سجد السهو and then تسليم. Because you took only one side. If you don't take one side and you are on both sides, likely to happen, you do sujud sahwi before taslim. So doubt for two, you want taslim. Doubt for only one, you are thinking that's weight, two taslims. وَيُسَلِّمَ ثُمَّ يَسُّدُ لِسَّهْوِ وَيُسَلِّمَ. مثال ذلك, example, شخص يصلي الظهر, someone is praying صلاة الظهر. فشك في الركعة, you have doubt in the ركعة you are praying, هل هي ثانية أو ثالثة, is it second ركعة or third ركعة, you are in doubt. Is that doubt 50-50 or we are outweighed one side? لكن ترجح عنده أنها ثالثة. Yeah. You outweighed, you think it is a third. You have doubt, you are not quite sure if you are third, but you think you are third. So what do you do? فإنه يجعلها ثالثة. Yeah. You build it as a third ركعة. فيأتي بعدها بركعة, and you bring extra ركعة with the fourth after that, ويسلم, and you say تسليم, السلام عليكم, السلام عليكم. ثم يشوت للسهوي, and then you do سجود السهوي, ثم ويسلم, and then you do تسليم. دليل ذلك, what is the evidence of this? What is the evidence of this? ما ثبت في الصحيحين, what has been narrated in صحيحين بخاري ومسلم وغيرهما, and also other books of hadith, من حديث عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وإذا شك أحدكم في صلاتي, if one of you in doubt in his salah, فليتحرى الصواب, we think which one is right, we make your own investigation which one is right. فليتم عليه, and then take what you think is right and complete your salah upon that. ثم يسجد سجدتين, and then do two sujuds. هذا لفظ البخاري. This is the version of Bukhari. الحالة الثانية the second one الله يترجح عنده واحد الأمرين yeah. there's no one you think is likely did you pray second are you in second or are you in third you don't know at all so that is we say 50-50 في عمل باليقين you take the one you are certain you done it هو الأقل the less number if you are in doubt second or third if you outweigh it third you build your salah on it but if you can't outweigh which one take the less one yeah, and complete your salah according to that فيتم عليه صلاته ويسجد للسهوي قبل أن يسلم when you are 50-50 one تسليم قبل أن يسلم ثم يسلم so that's what you have to remember when you should do sujood sahwi if you outweigh one of them you need two sujood if you are 50-50 you can't wait any you need one sujood one تسليم you need one تسليم مثال ذلك شخص يصلي العصر فشك في الركعة you are in doubt in the ركعة you are in هل هي ثانية أو ثالثة are you in the second ركعة or third ركعة ولم يترجح عنده but it is not likely to one side and you don't know whether it is second or third they're nearly equal to both sides so what do yeah فإنه يجعلها الثانية you assume it is second ركعة فيتشهد الشهود الأول and you do first الشهود yeah. ويأتي بعده بركعتين and then you add other two ركعة ويشهد للسهوي I bring you to السهوي ويسلم So it's 50-50, you do one taslim. You say before the taslim. I don't understand the shak. دليل ذلك ما رواه مسلم ما رواه مسلم عن أبي سعيد الخدري أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا شك أحدكم في صلاته If you are in doubt, yeah. in your salah, فلم يدركم صلى, and you don't know how many rak'ahs you've done, ثلاثاً أم أربعاً, either three or four rak'ahs. فليطرح الشك, yeah. put the doubtness on the side. وليبني على ما استيقن, and build your salah yeah. upon what you think. It's sure, which is in here, third raka. So my message then, قبل أن يسلم. Okay, now, third or fourth, you assume it third, you build your salah. Maybe it is fourth, isn't it? If it is fourth, and you are, it's for you, you assume it is third, how much are you praying in that case? Five. فإن صلى خمسة if he prayed five شفعنا له صلاته that sujood sahwi will correct your salah and make it four for you that's the benefit of sujood sahwi وإن كان صلى إتماما لأربعين if he was right and you prayed already yeah And you prayed already for yeah. it's a humiliation to the shaitan he wants to disturb you but your salah was right wanted to disturb you but your salah was right ومن أمثلة الشك some examples of the doubtness يصبح إن شاء الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. وصلى الله وسلم على النبي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.